Hello everyone, my name is Julien Garnier, I'm an engineer at Team Orphan Team at InnoRNG, and today I'm going to talk to you about embedded AR and connected stick for soil coverage estimation. So the stick is called the FACSTIC, is developed by InnoRNG Clermont-Ferrand, and is composed of different meteorological sensors like temperature, humidity, wind speed, wind direction, and pluviometry. Two cameras, one that takes a top-down view and one that takes a view at a 45 degree angle, and a computing unit to save the data of different sensors and send those data to a server. So we can see an example of the image taken by the stick. We got on the top the 45 degree angle one, and on the bottom top down view. Since the illumination of this image is pretty uneven, we apply illumination normalization. And once the image is normalized, we apply the Vegan model, a unit model with a resonant backbone, to predict the plant. So once we get the model, we got two questions. The first one is, can we run this model on the edge? And the second one is, how small can we make it? For that, we get a few options. The first one is to take the regional model and apply quantization, pruning, swap optimization, or conversion to a specialized library for low power systems such as TensorFlow Lite, that's now called LiteRT, or PyTorch Mobile, that's now called ExecuTorch. We can also train a new model using knowledge distillation. We can also train a Cold-Gomov Alert network, or we can train a TinyML, such with an architecture such as AtlantSeg, UNet Mobile Net, or MCUNet. So first we use the original Torch model, we quantize it, we converted it to Torch Mobile and to TensorFlow Lite. And we run it on the Raspberry Pi 4 with 4 GB of RAM. We can see that on the Raspberry Pi 4 that the Torch Mobile model got a very low die score. So next we run the same model on the JSON Nano with 2 GB of RAM. And on this system we can see that the Torch and Torch Quantize model take a very long time to run for one image, with about 5 minutes every images. And the last system we run the model is also a Raspberry Pi 4, but this time with 2 GB of RAM, and we can see similar results from the other type of system. So in conclusion, we opt to select the TensorFlow Lite model that can run on the lowest amount of RAM possible, but still relatively fast and with a pretty good die score. So next step we use knowledge distillation. So knowledge distillation is a deep learning method used to create a more efficient model in terms of computational cost by using a complex model that we call the t-chart to create soft targets for the training of the student model. The student model is less computational heavy, therefore better for deployment of this device. In this case, we are going to train two student models, one with a convolution encoder of depth 4 and another one with a depth 3. The two models are trained using the same dataset as the Vegan model, and the Vegan model is also used at the t-chart. And the model are trained using PyTorch, then converted to TensorFlow Lite. So here we can see the result of both models. So both student models got pretty similar results between them. And the main difference between the teacher model and student model is the size of the error predicted. The student model tend to predict the same error but with a larger size. And once we calculate the die score from the student model, we get a die score of 0.92. Next step is to run this model on the Raspberry Pi 4. To compare the time taken for the original model. So we can see a significant reduction of time for both student model, with the 3-depth model taking about half the time of the original Vegan model. However, the decrease in computational time isn't accompanied by the reduction in RAM usage. All three models use around 1.3 GB of RAM. And since all models used about the same amount of power during the inference, the only way to reduce the energy consumption of the model is to run faster. So the 3-depth model is the more energy efficient. So next we train the Cold-Gomov Alert network. So Cold-Gomov Alert network are deep learning model based on the theorem of the signal. This type of model allows for a size reduction for similar or better accuracy. The main difference between the CAN model and the standard model is that CAN model possess learnable activation function at the edge. However, the training of CAN model can be slower than other type of model. So here we're going to use a CAN variation called DuCAN. And this model is trained using the PyTorch library. And we're going to train two CAN models, one without preprocessing and one with the standard ImageNet dataset preprocessing. So here we can see the result of both models. So both models are trained on the Vegan dataset. And we can see that the error detected on the bottom of the image is good. But on the top of the image, we can see some ground is detected as plant. And once we calculate the die score, we can see that the first one without preprocessing got a die score of 0.71, and the second one with preprocessing is got a die score of 0.75. So the next step is to run this model on the Raspberry Pi. So we can see that the both CAN models take about half the time of the VGAN model. And the results are even more promising since the CAN model haven't been converted to TensorFlow Lite. They're still using the original Torch library. And we can also see that the CAN model use less RAM during the inference. They use 1.1 megabyte of RAM, but they got a spike at 1.8 gigabyte of RAM at the start of the inference. So in conclusion, the VGAN model gives us good results for segmentation of plant in both types of image. And once we convert this model to the TensorFlow Lite format, we can run it on single board computers, similar to one we can find on edge device. We also trained two models using knowledge distillation that gave us prediction close to the standard VGAN model, but with a faster inference time, but without a RAM usage gain. And we also trained two CAN models that give us good results. They are faster than the original model, but the results are a little less good than the distillation network. However, we can see RAM usage gain from both of these models. Thank you for your attention.